Hi, in this video I show you how to create a warehouse management sheet. It helps you keep track of incoming, outgoing and inventory. Also you can manage according to certain time period. And now the steps to create a warehouse management sheet. Here is the list of items in my inventory. I will manage the inventory with these items. First of all, I customize to make it easy for you to import items. You create a drop-down list with a list of SKUs. For each SKU, you can display a description of it in the cell next to it. You use a function called VLOOKUP to display the description. Don't forget to use the function called IFERROR when the SKU cell is empty. Then if the SKU cell is blank, the description cell will also be an empty cell. Next, copy the formula to the cell titled Unit. You change the Get Info column to get the contents of the cell titled Unit. Next, I copy the formulas of the column titled SKU down to the cells below it. Similarly, you copy the formulas from the cells with the title as description and unit down to the cells below them. Then you reformat the cells to make them easier to see. With the above method, you will easily create receipts. You just need to select the SKU, the information such as description and unit will be automatically updated in the next cells. Next, you copy the formulas for the exports. Just like in stock, every time you select a SKU when it comes out of stock, the information like the description and the SKU will automatically update in the next cells. I ended up copying the recipe to the items that were in stock. In the next section, I show you how to manage items during import and export and check inventory. I will be stocking a product with SKU of A001 with a quantity of 100. Next, you use the following formula to automatically update the inventory quantity. You use a formula named SUMIFS with the following conditions. You calculate the total imported quantity of items with SKU of A001. Because I want to track by certain periods, so I add condition from date to date. This function returns 0 because I haven't updated the date yet. So I created a drop-down list for the start date. I use a list of import and export dates to create a drop-down list. I then copy the formula to create a drop-down list of the end date. After updating the date, you will see the correct updated inventory results. I will add a new stock receipt with the item SKU as A001. Then I update the end date and you will see the stock has been added 50 more. What happens when I export an item with SKU of A001? I output the quantity as 30. Next, you edit the formula to get the correct inventory quantity. You take the quantity entered minus the quantity exported and get the remaining result. When you change the date, you will see a difference in the amount of inventory. In some cases, you export more quantity than stock and the result is less than zero. That's absurd, and I want to warn in that case by highlighting the cell with a different color. If the inventory quantity is less than zero, the cell will automatically turn red. When you update the correct amount, the cell automatically changes to the normal color. At this point, you have completed the export, import and inventory tracking for items with SKU of A001. You just do the same with the rest of the goods in your inventory. You copy the formula to calculate the inventory quantity of each item into the cells below for the remaining items in stock. Above is a simple inventory manager to help you keep track of your inventory. In addition, it also tells you the amount of inventory for a certain period of time. I put the sample file in the description for you to create your own inventory management sheet. Thanks for watching. Don't forget to like and subscribe. You will find many useful videos on my channel. Good luck.